Season 1 update is coming and we have a preview of what is to come. We are getting a new descendant, Haley Scott, and this is her first ability. Cry Around instantly fires a Cry Around that automatically tracks the enemy, deals damage, and inflicts Cryo, which deals additional damage along with Haley's firearm damage. This ability reminds me of the cannon from the Predator movies and it is pretty cool. Her second ability is Storm Snare, fires a freezing beam that unleashes a chill vortex around you and knocks back enemies, inflicts cryo on enemies that take damage. So basically, she drops a huge sniper rifle that damages nearby enemy as she grabs the weapon and the shot knockbacks enemy and it also deals chill damage. Her third ability is Cold Fury. Haley's movement speed gradually decreases, but her firearm and skill critical hit rate and firearm penetration all increases significantly. From what I can see, this ability slows her down and at the same time buffs her with firearm and skill critical hit rate and firearm penetration. Her ultimate ability is Zenith, replaces Haley's weapon with her unique weapon, anti-material sniper cannon. Penetration of the anti-material sniper cannon and firearm attack greatly increase and deal additional chill skill damage, recovers MP upon successfully attacking weak points, and decreases the cooldown the more bullets you have remaining when the skill ends. By far, this is the best looking ability that I've seen on this game and the flashiest. I don't usually use ultimate ability of my descendant because I'm mostly reliant on my weapons, but this ability is pretty damn cool and I hope that it will be very satisfying in terms of damage output. We are also going to get Ultimate Freyna and two ultimate weapons. The first weapon is the Excava, a powerful and versatile ultimate weapon. This assault rifle arrives with this update, also acquirable as a free battle pass reward. Excava charges voltage when attacking enemies and uses the charge voltage to fire energy grenades. The second weapon is Frost Watcher, acquirable through gameplay. This scout rifle reduces an enemy's chill resistance and increases your chill skill damage each time you hit the enemy at long range. It's a perfect weapon for Vesa or Haley who use chill attribute skills. We are also getting the new boss, Deathstalker. This is the Season 1 roadmap. August 29th is the first update and we are getting the new descendant, Haley and Haley skins, invasion dungeons, invasion reinforcement, and invasion season battle pass and ultimate weapon Excava. September 26th, second update, we are getting the new intercept battle, Deathstalker, ultimate weapon Frost Watcher, that's the new scout rifle. We are also getting the new ultimate skins and ultimate descendants exclusive spawn effects. October 30, third update, we are finally getting the Ultimate Freyna and Freyna exclusive story. Ultimate Freyna modification modules, Haley modification modules, new ultimate modules, highest difficulty infiltration operation, and ETA 0. ETA 0 is a merchant that sells items and tradables such as blueprints for descendants and ultimate weapons and hard to find consumables. This in PC is like Baruketeer in Warframe. We are also getting a quality of life change in hard infiltration operation and we are also getting improvements on the socket types. Now, once you assign a socket type, the socket type granted to that slot is permanently saved, so you can easily change it to the previously granted socket type at any time. For example, if a descendant changes an Almandine socket to a Malachite socket, you can easily choose between Almandine and Malachite in that socket afterwards. Additionally, the socket type applied to the loadout setting 1 can also be used for settings 2 and 3 as well, allowing you to grant multiple socket types only to the slot that require multiple socket types depending on your builds. This is a big W for the players because as of right now, there are so many builds. But because we can only install one specific socket type, it really stops us from making another build. And with this update, we can finally create different builds for specific situations. There are also changes for Jaber, Blair, and Ajax, which is pretty awesome. Huge win for the players who play these descendants. These are the upcoming update in season 1. All in all, these are massive changes and I'm very excited for the new season. I will link the update down below if you guys want to read the whole thing. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.